Hi, Gude YouTube. I'm Max and you're watching Random Old School Yu-Gi-Oh! And as you can see, I got some mail. It's a pretty big parcel and I will try to unpack it so you can see what I got. This is a mixture of sealed products and some older promo cards. And I will try to open the package without damaging anything, of course, and without showing the address of the seller. So just in case there's something I'm not too happy with, I can just try to make it work out so the seller and I both can agree on something without them being shown on YouTube to whatever. Whoops. Okay. Oh. Whoop. That camera movement. Yay. See? Whoops. I can put the stuff down here, I think. So I can just put the camera down a little. Yay. Okay, so one of the products I opened a lot of, and a product that I like, it's Legendary Collection 4. And as mentioned in other videos, the Joey version is way cheaper in Italian than it is in English. And so that's why I got, let's see, 5 of those. Now I have to be careful. Let's do it like this. Because I feel like there should be, yes, an envelope too. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They were described as being slightly damaged when unpacking them. Maybe there's a little bit, but overall I think they look decent. I wouldn't have complained if they were sold like undamaged, because the boxes themselves are pretty sturdy, so even if they had some nick over here, wait, there's a little bit of the outer wrapping that's damaged, but nothing too crazy. And whoop, I can make some space over here, so I have just one layer of boxes down here. The more exciting thing for me, at least, is if the cards I bought are in mint condition as they were listed. Oh. Wait, that's all? So I got some Master Collection 1 and some Master Collection 2 Secret Rare promo cards, being Barrel Dragon, and not just one, but some more. Oh, wait. I hope that's on the sleeve, because I can feel something here. Yeah, that was on the sleeve. So that looks nice in my book. Back has some scuffing on it, a little bit over here, but that's okay, I think. Let's give it a new home, because that sleeve was very worn. You can see it like, yeah, that was what I felt, and I was scared for a second, because I thought, oh no, it's on the card, but it wasn't. Second Barrel Dragon, and that's a spoiler for the next card, because you can see it underneath. Yeah, that's Okay, it has a little ding up here. And the edge is a little... Okay, I think if that's the worst condition of cards in here, that would be okay. But there shouldn't be more cards like this with worn edges and that dot on the back. Just grabbing some more sleeves here, so I don't have to get the package out like for every card. Next up, there is a secret rare relinquished. That's from MC12.
1-2.
Yeah, nice. I mean, the starter deck Pegasus and Magic Ruler / Spell Ruler Ultra Rare looks nice, but it has something going for it in Secret Rare as well, I think. It's a nice looking card. Yeah. That looks okay. One of my favorite old school cards is the next one. That's Dark Necrophyr. It's another MC1 card. And there should be a playset in here. Nice. I had this out of Labyrinth of Nightmare back in the day. I think I had a playset. I traded the first one when I was like in 7th grade, I think. And some friends and I went back to my primary school and went there to trade with the younger kids, because not too many kids in the middle school played Yu-Gi-Oh! And yeah, you could get some good trades, I would say, with younger kids. I think I traded a bunch of common cards, including the Mighty Crab Turtle with the ritual card for it, because I had the fiends to special summon this, and rituals were easier to summon, you could say. But of course, neither my deck or the decks of other people around were competitive, so in terms of rarity, I think that was a good deal for me, and not a too good one for whoever that other kid was. But whatever, we both were happy, and yes, Dark Necrophyr is still one of my all-time favorite cards. Another one. Oh, this has, you can see it here, there's some damage. It's light, but I wouldn't list this as near mint. There's something too. Yeah, and that's on the card, and not a little bit of dust or something. What's not bothering me is the off-centering that both cards actually have. They are very thin at the bottom, and the top is a little bit wider. Third Dark Necrophyr, let's see. Yeah, this has a lot more of Secret Rare foiling than Relinquished, for example, but I like it on Relinquished because there's more detail in combination with the foiling. But for Dark Necrophyr, the dark background gets sparkled up a little, which looks nice, cool, nice too. I'm losing my English skills over here, live and on camera. Yeehaw. Can't think of anything better than that. but it's Friday. It was a long week. And as you can see, this one is as off-centered as the other ones. Last card. Unfortunately, I didn't get a Black Luster Soldier or anything, because I just bought these in addition to the boxes, because shipping was very high, and I thought, can I get some more stuff without increasing shipping costs? So it's a better ratio of product I get if I have to pay high shipping. This is from Italy, by the way. So from Italy to Germany, and it was here in like 1 or 2 days, which is very fast. I didn't expect that. So this is Guardian Sphinx from MC2, the second Master Collection. Okay, this is a card that I don't have too fond memories of, because I didn't play it myself, but I was once... I was once locked with a Guardian Sphinx and Yata Garasu, so my monsters were bounced continuously to my hand, and Yata attacked so I couldn't draw, and I had no auto it, so that was that. This was when some friends and I went to the next bigger town, quotation marks for bigger. We live in a small village, and we obviously could only play with like 4 or 5 different people. And then we went to the next city, and there were other peoples who played way better decks than we had. And that's one of the memory I have from that time. They went to some kind of fast food restaurant and played Yu-Gi-Oh! There, which was funny too. And there I got Yata locked, not with CED, but with Guardian Sphinx and Yata. So, bad times for me, good times for them, I think. So, a bunch of overall nice promo cards. One or two I wouldn't have listed as near mint, but okay, they might be excellent, which isn't too big of a difference. The boxes look nicer than I expected, and you can expect me to open some of them, or some packs, because I like opening LC4, I like opening LC3, even though that's way more expensive and I can do that way fewer than I can open this one. And I can speak Italian, or I can attempt to do so while doing that, and this is funny as well, because when I'm already losing my tongue out of control for speaking English, which I'm more used to, then Italian would be hilarious, and maybe I can improve my channel in another direction, being comedy. No, but whatever. I'm talking trash right now. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for watching, and see you next time for maybe some openings of LC4 at Random Old School Yu-Gi-Oh! Goodbye!